Hello kids, welcome back to LKME online class. This is Nikita Barik. I hope you all are fit and fine and watching all the videos and learning from home as LKME school has provided you this facility that is LKME online class. So in my previous video, we already studied about the poem. Which poem I'm talking about? Daddy fell into the pond. And who wrote this poem? That is Alfred Noyes. So in that video, what we studied, let me summarize it for you very quickly. In first stanza, what we studied, the children were feeling so dull, that is dismal, nothing humor or happiness happened from the whole day, and the sky was getting so gray and the day was about to end, and they were not even expecting something good to happen the rest of the day. And all of a sudden, which incident happened? That is Daddy fell into the pond. As soon as the daddy fell into the pond, what happened? The children bursted into giggles, all started laughing on that moment. Even the Timothy started dancing and was asking for the camera. Why he was asking for the camera? To capture the moment. Which moment I'm talking about? The daddy fell into the pond. As the daddy was coming out of the duckweeds, he wanted to capture that moment for lifelong, and they can laugh all the time. Okay. Even the gardener who was watching this whole scenario, he also started laughing, though he was not showing that he is laughing, but he was tapping his knee and was laughing. And who else were getting mad into this scenario was the ducks. Ducks even got crazy into the pond. They were also, deft word is being used, which means getting mad or getting crazy. So all this scenario was creating humor for the children. Though nothing happened from the whole day, but by the end of the day, something happiness was created for the kids, and that was Daddy falling down into the pond. So that was the summary of the poem, that is Daddy fell into the pond. Now let's have discussion on Q&A. Let's discuss the few question answers that I've got for you. Please always sit with a notebook and a pencil so that you can also try to answer, or you can also write the answers. Okay, let's read the first question. Why did everyone grumble in the poem? Who are everyone over here? Obviously the children. Okay, so why they were grumbling? Grumbling means, I already explained you in word buddies, grumble means complaining. Why they were complaining about the day, it has been asked to us. So everybody was grumbling on that day because the day was so dismal, that is it was very dull and nothing exciting or happening thing happened for the whole day, and the day was about to end. So the kids were grumbling due to this reason, as nothing good or excitement thing happened to them. Next question is, why was the day dismal to the narrator? Dismal means dull to the narrator. Why the narrator is considering the day as dull? See students, the day becomes bright and merry when something good or exciting thing happens to you, but on that day the sky already grew wholly grey. So till that time nothing good thing happened, so the narrator considered it as a dismal day, that is a dull day. Third question, how did this dismal day turn into merrymaking? Obviously you know the incident, the very good incident, not a good incident, but just to make kids laugh, it was a good incident. Which incident happened in the poem? That is Daddy falling down into the pond. He fell down into the pond and the children bursted into laughter. They started giggling on it. So how it turned into the merrymaking? When Daddy falling down into the pond, it became a merrymaking for the kids. Next is, why did Timothy ask for the camera? Why did he ask for the camera? Whenever we are asking for the camera means we want to capture some or the other moment. Timothy started dancing in the poem when he saw that Daddy fell down into the pond, and he wanted to capture that moment so that whenever he'll have a look to the picture, he can laugh at any time. So he quickly was asking for the camera to capture that particular moment. So he asked for the camera to capture the moment, that is Daddy fell into the pond. Next question, how did the ducks respond to the situation? How did the duck respond? They started quacking so madly. Okay, they got mad when they were quacking, and they responded to the scenario. Which scenario or situation? That is Daddy fell down into the pond. One word is also used for them, that is old drac. Okay, like old male ducks. Okay, so this five questions I discussed with you. One more question I have, that you have to give your opinions, or you have to write, according to you, what did the daddy feel when the children or the surrounding people were laughing on daddy? Okay, so you have to write in your notebook your own views or opinions. Okay, so next, one more topic is there to discuss. So the next topic that we have to study is a type of figure of speech, and in fourth standard for now we have just have to study alliteration. Alliteration is a type of a figure of speech. Now let's talk about what is a figure of speech. When a sentence, or we can also say a phrase, is there where exaggerated thing is used to give more effect to a sentence or a phrase, we call it as a figure of speech. And the type that we are learning today is alliteration. Now what is alliteration? Alliteration means in a phrase or in a sentence. Have you ever heard about tongue twister? Have you seen or heard it? When we are speaking it, same sound will come again and again. That is repetition of letter or repetition of sound. We call it as alliteration, type of figure of speech. Got it? Let's study the example of what is alliteration. The first example is black bug bit a big black bear. Okay, so see, we are having problem in pronouncing also. Okay, as the same letters are repeating, which letter is repeating over here again and again? B. That is black bug beat a big black bear. So there is a repetition of sound also, and there is a repetition of letter also. So we call it as alliteration. Got it? And students, one more thing, take care about it, that alliteration doesn't only mean the repetition of letter, also if the sound is same, then also we can call it as alliteration. Let's read the second example. Sheep should sleep in a shed. Which letter is repeating over here? S. And the sound is also S is repeated again and again in a sentence, or we can say a phrase also. Okay, this sentences we can also call, or this phrases we can also call it as tongue twister, where our tongue is twisting again and again. Okay, we are not able to pronounce it in a proper manner. Next, third is Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. Oh my god, it's lot of time our tongue is being twisted for this. Okay, so that we call it as alliteration. Again and again, which letter was repeated? That is P, and the sound of P is repeated again and again. Now last example that I have got is come and clean the clothes. Okay, come, a very simple sentence I have used here, come and clean the clothes. Which letter is repeated over here? That is C, and the sound of C is also being repeated here again and again. So we can call it as alliteration. And please do write one tongue twister in your notebook. So many tongue twister you might be knowing, you have studied in your earlier class as well. So that's all for the day today. Thank you. Have a nice day.